Today's baking day, and I'm trying to do a whole batch of stuff in one go. First thing I'm going to do is use up almost a whole pack of sausages. I'm going to make a sausage casserole using the soup kit thing that I got the other day and adding a few extra bits to it. I'm also going to make toad in the hole, which I've been thinking about for weeks now. And I'm going to make a wartime style bread and apple pudding. It's basically bread pudding, but with some apple in it. And I have two recipes for this, but I'm going to do the one with the egg in it because I have a lot of eggs at the moment. So the first thing I need to do is I'm going to brown off all my sausages. In the pan and set them on a low heat. Prick them so they don't explode. Right, this is going to be a very simple dish. Half a stock cube. Mix easier if it's already been chopped into bits. I'm going to put the veg in there. Ooh, it smells nice. And we'll stick that in there. Now, I'm just trying to decide what else I'm going to put with this. There's not an awful lot in it. There's a lot of onion. We have swede, turnip and carrot by the looks of it. It's not going to be an enormous casserole. With all the sausages and what have you, it should be good. Now, what I could do discount butter beans. I've had these last year, and I think I might. What do I want? One of those. I think I might add those in. I think they'll be really nice. I want to make something that's going to last 2 or 3 days. So let's just open the butter beans. Sieve. Get the whole lot in there, I think. Rinse them off. At the moment. And then I'm going to lob these straight in to the dish. There are going to be 4 sausages in this. The other 2, I am going to turn in the hole. Now, let's find my toad in the hole recipe, or my batter recipe anyway. So you don't need an awful lot to make batter. You can buy them ready-made, but I don't. Simple as. And one of the things I like to do to make sure I've stirred it up properly is I do it in a jar. So let's give this a go. So, one egg, which I'm going to crack into my jar. Little bit of salt. This is half a teaspoon, but my god, that's a lot. A little bit of salt in there. Egg in the jar. I need 55 grams of plain flour. You can't actually see any of this, can you? This is me putting the flour into the jar with my egg. Then I need 150 mils of milk. Milk is straight out the freezer. So that's 60. That's 150. And then all you have to do is get your lid on nice and tight. Better mix than that. So put a bit of oil into the pan there. Get that around. This is going to be lunch today. I'm not very organised. I've been running around all morning sorting out things that I had to send in emergency to the post office, battling with Esure to try and get my car insurance quote dealt with. More on that to come, because oh boy, wasn't that interesting. And paying off my national insurance. I'm going to do a separate video on that at the end of the month. There's all sorts of financial stuff going on. Right, so, four sausages, they're browned, so they can go in here. Make sure they're nice and organised. That's how that looks. and I'm going to top it up with some water. Pop the lid on, and that's going to go into the oven. And we'll pop that on about 180, something like that. So that's that bit done. Those sausages I'm going to put into the dish where the batter pudding is going to go. Right, apparently that mixture needs to sit for half an hour, which is fine because I have other stuff to do. We are going to make this bread and butter pudding. So let's leave those aside. Bread and butter pudding time. So I have all my bread. It says 10 slices, but whatever. I have the last two apples, which I'm going to put into the mixture. First thing I'm going to do is get my bread slices. Five, six, eight, nine, ten. There we go. Put that away for another one. That can go into the freezer. And we're going to break all of this bread into this. And it's literally just a case of just crumbling it up. There's nothing fancy about it. As I go. Because lunch is running late today. This recipe calls for grated apple, one large grated apple, and then dried fruit. Well, I don't have any dried fruit because that stuff is not cheap at the moment. So I've stopped buying dried fruit. It seems unnecessary. The problem is that once I've opened a packet and it's in the cupboard, I eat it like a snack, and then it doesn't get used for the purpose that I bought it for. So stop buying it, which is fine because it's really expensive at the moment, dry fruit. So here we go. There's all the bread, all ready to go. Need to add a little water just to dampen it down, and I'll probably put two of those, so that'll probably work out at about 100 mil of water. It soaks up a lot, so just be careful that you don't make it too soggy. You're supposed to squeeze it out, but I would rather put less in to start with and just be more careful with it. There we go, that'll probably do. As always, I am slapdash. Right, now I need to add in a whole bunch of other ingredients. The first thing I'm going to do is chop up my apples. Two small apples here. I'm just going to chop these up into small bits. We're not peeling them, we're not fussing around with any of that. We are literally just going to dice these up. Some bruised bits on this one, so we need to cut out the bruises. Also need my one egg beaten. One egg there. And what else? A little milk to mix. So just a little bit of milk to add to that. You don't want to make the bread pudding too pork. You don't want to make it too wet, otherwise it won't cook well. Give that a mixer. It says cinnamon to taste, but I think I'm going to mix it all round because I don't have the dried fruits. I think I might just put a load of cinnamon in. And work it into the whole thing. Now it has down. I also need 2 ounces of margarine, but I think the margarine is just for greasing the tin that this will go into, except I don't bother. I just leave it where it is. So I've just mixed it into one bowl. So let's wash it up. I just can't be bothered. So, there's that. And now I mix this in. Is that right? Yeah, mix all that in. Far from the perfect way of doing this, but honestly, I'm not in the mood for perfection today, as if I ever am. So there we are. And I mean, that's basically it. That is a wartime bread pudding minus a couple of ingredients. I am going to add a little bit more cinnamon to the top, and then as it cooks, as it starts to get close to being cooked, you can sprinkle a little bit more sugar on it, but that depends entirely on your sweet tooth. If you prefer something that's a bit more savoury, you could reduce the sugar or up the fruit content, depending on what suits you. So that is basically my bread and butter pudding. So I'm going to leave that there for the moment, because I don't want to cook it too soon. I was also going to make some cookies. I saw a recipe for whole wheat cookies, but I just can't be bothered today. And to be honest with you, these pans are so big, I don't think I'm going to be able to fit anything else into the oven anyway. So I still have 20 minutes before my batter's ready. So I'm just going to tidy up, and you're just going to have to wait, sorry. Short on fruit veg, so I'm just going to make up a couple of bits to go with my toad in the hole for lunch. Very small potato. Little roast chunks, and then and cut those into mini batons. I'll pop those in there. And then they can go straight into the oven with a bit of oil. And that'll be that sorted. Casserole will sit in its dish for ages. I've got the lid on, so that shouldn't be a problem. Right, that needs about 10 minutes. I'll leave that can wait there. That's it. Oh, highly disorganised today, not good. Time for a cup of tea. This is what happens when you try to do too many dishes at once and you've been too disorganised in the morning to get yourself properly organised. I was supposed to do this cooking thing yesterday and then decided I would do it Friday because I had all the wrong things that needed eating first, so doing oven food wasn't going to work yesterday. And now today, doing lots of finance stuff in the morning that had deadlines. I just wasn't ready. So like I'm doing my cooking when I should normally be having lunch. And it doesn't really matter, but it just kind of knocks me out of my routine because I like to be organised and doing things the way that works. This afternoon I have an Etsy thing to package up. Yes, I sold something on Etsy. And also I've sold something else on Vinted, which needs to go out. So I'm gonna try and get those packaged and out this afternoon. It's really windy again today, but it's very sunny. So I'm hoping that, this is why I didn't want lunch to be really late, because it has a knock-on effect for the afternoon. Right, cup of tea time. Batter time. So you can actually see what I'm doing this time. Very simple. Batter's ready. Batter goes in. And that's basically it. Now that can go into the oven, I think for about 20 minutes, but as with everything that I do, I do it based purely on, does it look cooked? Does it taste cooked? It's probably cooked. So I'm going to pop this into the oven. And I'm also going to pop these into the oven. I've got no oil on, so that won't take too long. And I'm also going to put this in. Here we go. Clean that out, which is just as easy as when I made the batter. Now it's clean enough to go in the wash. Here we go. So, now I'm just going to wait for my toad in the hole to be done. And then that's lunch done. I might split that in half and have half of it later because there's a lot of it. I see, I've got casserole as well now. I have so many options. Where do you start? Anyway, so I'm gonna wait now about 20 minutes and show you what toad in the hole looks like when it's done. Yummy! I think toad in the hole is ready, so let's have a look. Stuck. Oh dear. Tastes good. That's what lunch looks like today.